Since 2016, Kohli has been in splendid form, aggregating 5,363 at an average of 76.61, including 1800s and 2250s, in 83 matches in international cricket. He remains the only batsman to amass 5,000 runs since the said period. PTI updated December 3, 2017, 2,344 PM. Is New Delhi Virat Kohli's sixth double century as captain was put in the backseat on the second day, due to complaints made by the Sri Lankan contingent about the air pollution in the capital city. Two Sri Lankan players, Lahiru Gamage and Suronga Lakmal, returned to the pavilion, leaving the fielding team short of players, which forced Kohli to declare India's first innings at 5,367. The second session of the match was delayed by more than 20 minutes due to the worsening smog. Sri Lanka were at 13-13, with Angelo Matthews 57 and skipper Dinesh Chandamal 25 on the pitch when the umpires decided to stop the play due to bad light. The statistical highlights on day two of the third cricket test between India and Sri Lanka of Virat Kohli's 243 is his highest individual innings in tests at Faraz Shah Kotla, Delhi, eclipsing New Zealand's Bert Sutcliffe's 230 not out versus India in December 1955. Vinod Kambla's 227 off 301 balls in 413 minutes versus Zimbabwe in March 1993 was the previous highest score by an Indian batsman at this venue. Kohli has established a record for the highest individual innings by an Indian captain in tests, bettering his own 235 versus England at Wankhede Stadium, Mumbai in December 2016. Kohli has created cricket history by becoming the first captain to record six double centuries in tests, eclipsing Brian Lara's tally of five. Besides Kohli and Kambli, four other Indian players have recorded double hundreds in tests at Faraz Shah Kotla. Nawabh Pathaudi Jr., Rahul Dravid, Gautam Gambhir, VVS Laxman. Kohli has recorded strike rate of 81.87 while amassing 560 avenue 186.66 during the current rubber. The same is his best ever in a test series of minimum three tests, eclipsing the 63.31 while totaling 692 avenue 86.50 in the Fortis series versus Australia in 201,415. Kohli's strike rate of 81.87 in the above rubber is the highest by an Indian skipper in a test series when at least 400 runs have been scored. The previous best was registered by Muhammad Izzaruddin 79.47 while scoring 426 runs in three tests five innings at an average of 85.20 versus England in 1990. Kohli's runs tally of 560 avenue 186.66 is the most by an Indian batsman in a three test series, eclipsing Virendra Sehwag's aggregate of 544 avenue 90.66, including two centuries versus Pakistan in India in 200,405. Kohli became the second Indian player after Vinu Mankad versus New Zealand in 195,556 and the 13th in all to post two innings of 200 in the same test series. Don Bradman had achieved the feat four times, including three innings of 200-plus versus England in 1930. Since 2016, Kohli has been in splendid form, aggregating 5,363 at an average of 76.61, including 1800s and 2250s, in 83 matches in international cricket. He remains the only batsman to amass 5,000 runs since the said period. Also see India vs Sri Lanka, third test. Furious Ravi Shastri confronts umpires in Delhi, watched since recording his first double century in 2016-200 against West Indies at North Sound by Kohli. No other skipper has posted even a single double century in tests. Joe Root's 190 versus South Africa at Lord's in July this year is the highest by any other captain during this period. With six double centuries in tests, Kohli has equaled an Indian record, held by Sachin Tendulkar and Virendra Sehwag. With 1,009 runs avenue 77.61 in 10 tests in 2017, Kohli is the first Indian captain to complete 1,000 runs in a calendar year twice. Last year, he had totaled 1,215 runs at an average of 75.93 in 12 tests. Apart from Kohli, two Indian captains have achieved the distinction: Sachin Tendulkar in 1997 and Rahul Dravid in 2006. Kohli became the first Indian skipper to amass 500 runs in a three-test series. with 213 in the second test at Jamtha, Nagpur. He became the sixth batsman to register two double hundreds in consecutive innings, joining England's Wally Hammond twice, 192,829 and 193,233, Australia's Don Bradman 1934, India's Vinod Kambli 199,293, Sri Lanka's Kumar Sangakkara 2007 and Australia's Michael Clarke 201,213. Kohli's tally of 560 is the third highest by a captain in a three-test series, behind Graham Gooch 752 at an average of 125.33 versus India in 1990 and Michael Clarke 576 at an average of 144.00 versus South Africa in 201,213. Captains completing 500 runs or more in a three-test series after their 173-run stand for the fifth wicket versus Sri Lanka at Nagpur, Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma were associated in a vital stand of 135 for the same wicket in the Delhi Test. India's 536 for 7 wickets declared is the highest versus Sri Lanka in tests at Firoz Shah Kotla, Delhi, obliterating the 375 for 6 wickets declared in December 2005. India have recorded their joint third highest total at Firoz Shah Kotla, the highest ever at this venue being 613 for 7 wickets declared versus Australia in 200,809. Rohit Sharma has posted 4 consecutive innings of 50-plus for the first time in Tests, 82 at Eden Gardens at Kolkata, 51 not out at Indore both versus New Zealand in 2016, followed by an unbeaten 102 at Nagpur, 65 at Delhi both versus Sri Lanka. Rohit's 65 is his third 50 versus Sri Lanka, his eighth in tests. Between 2013 and 2015, Rohit had managed 896 runs in 16 tests at an average of 33.18, including 200s and 450s, and since 2016, he has totaled 455 in 9 innings, 7 tests at an average of 75.83, including 100 and 450s. Also see India versus Sri Lanka, third test. Angry Virat Kohli declares after Sri Lankans complain of Delhi smog. Watch Dimuth Karunaratne has posted his 10th duck in tests, his third versus India. Angelo Matthews unbeaten 57 is his 29th 50 in tests, his fifth versus India. In 9 tests this year, Matthews has recorded 3 50s.